Hello everybody. Today we finished off riveting the side skins of the tail cone and started with dimpling and preparing the center section. So we started with the right side skin of the tail cone. In the previous session we already riveted the left side skin and the bottom skin of the tail cone, but the session took so long that we couldn't rivet the right side skin. So we riveted in this session first. Fortunately my dad had time, so we could do it together, which is much easier because, as you can see, you almost have to dive into the tail cone to be able to buck the rivets. I'm not sure how people do it on their own, but some people do apparently. It is especially hard because the J channels, which we have to rivet, are the rivets are beneath them, so that's harder. Every time when we reach a bulkhead, we rivet that bulkhead too, and then we continue with the J channels. First the bottom J channel, and then the top J channel. With riveting the bulkhead, you have to be careful, because you shouldn't go higher than the top J channel, which is actually in the middle there, because the longer ones should also be able to be inserted, and you do that by bending the side skin a little bit outward and then insert the longer ones. So that's why you cannot rivet it all to the top, because then you wouldn't be able to insert the longer ones. For now we are just riveting the side skin, and at the end, the aft part where the elevator is will be attached, there I could do it with the squeezer, because there is space and room for the squeezer to get in. Of course the yoke is not big enough to be able to rivet these side skins, so we have to do that with the rivet gun and the bucking bar. You have to be careful there in the end, because there are different thicknesses of skin, and also J channels and bulkheads. So on several places you have to use longer rivets, so you have to be very careful and watch the call-outs, the rivet length call-outs on the drawings, or else you'll make mistakes, which we did. So I think there are two rivets that I screwed up in this session, so they have to be drilled out and then reset. You will see that we do it here. So we remove the rivet gun and use the drill. It was hard to drill them out, as you can see, and that's because there is not enough room inside to get the bottom part of the rivet out of the hole. But eventually it worked, and we reset those rivets. Also, there are some rivets we have to set on the side. You cannot set them from the bottom, and you cannot set them from the top side, so you do it when it's on its side. So we do it now. There are only two or three rivets you have to set this way. Yeah, three apparently. Done. So now the tail cone is done for now. So we continue with the center section. Just look into the drawings, and again there is not much explanation left in the manual, so you have to just look at drawings and then figure out what needs to go where. Already primed and drilled, match drilled all the holes. So next part is dimpling. There are two parts that need to be dimpled. The skin, that's the one you can see there. So we use the DRDT2 for that. So my dad does all the dimpling of the skin, while I am working on the ribs, mostly dimpling the ribs and making some small changes that still need to be done. So after this dimpling session, we can start really assembling everything. And then we can, once the center section is assembled, we can attach it to the tail cone that we just created. So that would really be nice, because then it's actually becoming quite big. So I'm really enthusiastic about that. There are a few lines you shouldn't dimple yet, because there are some overlaps. So where the center section is connected to the tail cone, and also where it will be connected later to the main bulkhead, the bulkhead where the wings are also attached to, those should not be dimpled, or at least not now. And some need to be, some holes need to be countersunk, so you have to be careful there. Again, check the drawings to see the correct settings for that, because it's very easy to make mistakes there, and you have to be careful. What I'm doing currently is I use some plate nuts that are necessary to attach the floor panel. You need to use a thread tap to make it a little bit easier to go in there, because mostly nut plates, they are, those almost look like they are a little bit squeezed. So after they have been threaded in the factory, it looks like they're squeezed, just to make it, let's say, impossible for bolts or screws to get out. But since the seat panel is not very there's not very much room, they say that you should thread it. Oh, there I make actually a mistake. We were inserting the nut plates on the ribs, and while we were doing that, I thought, hey, maybe it's easy to also attach the 10 nut plates that need to be attached to the baggage seat side. Which wasn't very smart, because actually there is another baggage panel, floor panel, that the nut plates should also go through. So the rivets which attach the nut plates go through the floor panel, then through the rib, and then into the nut plate, which is I've never seen that before until now. And so I had to drill all those holes out in a later session when I figured out that it was wrong. Okay, continuing next time, building my pie in the sky.